What is going on, everybody? It's your boy, SnowBikeMike, back with your daily gaming hype reports. Today is Friday, October 25th, 2019, and here are the top gaming headlines that you need to know about. Remember, if you like any of the stories that I bring to you today, please go to the articles directly and support those incredible games journalists around the globe. Story links can be found in the show description below, so let's get into it. Here are the top four stories that you need to know about.
Story number one, The Last of Us Part 2 release date delayed to May. This story from IGN.com by Jonathan Dornbush. The story reads, despite announcing The Last of Us Part 2's 2020 release date just a few weeks ago, PlayStation and Naughty Dog have confirmed a delay for the highly anticipated sequel. The Last of Us Part 2 has been delayed to May 29th, 2020. Naughty Dog's Neil Druckmann, who also serves as creative director on Part 2, confirmed in a PlayStation blog post. Quote, let me cut to the chase and get the news out of the way. The Last of Us Part 2 has a new release date of May 29th, 2020, Druckmann wrote. I know it's just about a month ago when we had our big blowout for the game, letting media play over 2 hours of it along with debuting our new story trailer and revealing the release date. The positive response we saw from the community was overwhelming. You can feel the energy among the team members after working on something for so many years. It's invigorating to get a glimpse of validation for all the hard work, end quote. Druckmann said that despite the recent announcement of a February release date for the sequel, quote, we realized we simply didn't have enough time to bring the entire game up to a level of polish we would call Naughty Dog quality, end quote. All right, everybody, I know some somber news to end the week on the Hype Report, but take that frowning face and make it a smiling face because you know Naughty Dog and the team are going to give you one of the best games of the generation, maybe even in video game history with The Last of Us Part 2. And they said, hey, we're going to push this game back just a little bit. We're going to give it that extra quality. We're going to elevate the gameplay, and we're going to ensure that this is the best Naughty Dog game that you can play. So May 29th. 2020 will be the new release date for The Last of Us Part 2, and I gotta say, you know what? I'm totally okay with it because my birthday's in May, and now I get to celebrate my birthday month with an awesome Naughty Dog exclusive game, but also because I love hearing that the team really enjoyed the community overwhelming support for them and their release with the media event and the new story trailer. And I love hearing that the team was reinvigorated. They were excited. They were ecstatic that people loved what they put out. And then they said, you know what? Let's channel that energy. Let's make sure that we give the best product possible when we come out with this game. So let's push it back a month. Let's give it some love. Let's give it a little bit of extra oomph to get it down the pipeline. And I cannot wait now for May for this new release date. And of course, The Last of Us Part 2. Story number two, Ubisoft delays Watch Dogs Legion, Rainbow Six Quarantine, and Gods and Monsters. This story from GameSpot.com by Chris Pereira. The story reads, three of Ubisoft's biggest upcoming games have been delayed. Release dates for Watch Dogs Legion, Rainbow Six Quarantine, and Gods and Monsters are now all scheduled for the company's 2020-2021 fiscal year. That means the soonest we can expect to see any of them is April 2020. Previously, Watch Dogs Legion was set for March 6th, and Gods and Monsters was scheduled for February 25th. Rainbow Six Quarantine was set for this fiscal year, which ends on March 31st. The new fiscal year targets mean the games will release by March 31st, 2021. In an investor call, Ubisoft suggested Watch Dogs Legion and Gods and Monsters are planned for the second half of 2020. Specific release dates for none of the games were announced, while a fourth, Skull and Bones, has also apparently been pushed back until at least April 1st, 2021. In a statement, Ubisoft CEO Yves Guillemot explained that its recent AAA releases have been met with disappointing reception, in particular Ghost Recon Breakpoint. He says this is partially due to live games coming too close together and not having enough differentiation. He also more generally said that new features aren't being given the time to be perfectly optimized. It's in this context that he says delays on these next three projects are necessary. I know, everybody out there, I'm giving you two back-to-back delay stories to really get you down on a Friday, but hey, Like I said in the last story, turn that frown, flip it upside down, because just like the team from Naughty Dog, Ubisoft knows that these three upcoming titles are big and very important to them and their different development teams, so they gotta ensure that they take the time to put the love and care into all of them. Watch Dogs Legion is gigantic. Getting to see it at E3, the ambitious project that they're trying to do with this game really leads to me to say, hey, you know what, if you need more time to put in the right systems to ensure that the process is working well, take that time, because Watch Dogs looks awesome. Gods and Monsters looks like a ton of fun, and that stole the Ubisoft show for me when I was at their live presentation. And of course, Rainbow Six Quarantine, everybody loves Rainbow Six Siege. The resurgence of that community and that game in everybody's eyes is huge, and they gotta ensure that they come out with a banger for Rainbow Six Quarantine, because they don't want to have any bad publicity around that name. So Ubisoft taking the time to say, hey, let's make sure these three big upcoming titles for us are perfect is the right move, and I'm totally okay with it. I do want to bring up that fourth title though, Skull and Bones. I was sold on it a long time ago, and I'm still waiting for it. Ubisoft, give me Skull and Bones, and really, give me Roller Champions. I know you're listening to me right now, Ubisoft team. I want Roller Champions in my hand right away. That game is so good. Please don't delay that game, Roller Champions. I love it. Story number three. Mixer signs exclusive deal with Shroud. This story from GamesIndustry.biz by Brendan Sinclair. The story reads, Mixer has signed away another big Twitch live streamer. A couple months after Tyler Ninja Blevins committed to the Microsoft streaming platform, Michael Shroud Greziak announced today that he too has reached a deal to exclusively stream gameplay and video through Mixer. Shroud leaves behind a Twitch channel with more than 7 million followers to start anew, although he has amassed more than 36,000 followers on his freshly minted Mixer channel within an hour of announcing his move. Quote, streaming is my passion and I owe my success to my fans who have helped me get to where I am now, Shroud said. Mixer provides the flexibility to center my attention around them. I'm excited to join the Mixer community as well as continue to build relationships with both players and fans, end quote. Shroud and Ninja are both represented by the management company Loaded, which represents a stable of influencers including Lyric, Dr. Lupo, and Ammunition. Wow, isn't this a wild story for our Friday? Shroud, one of the largest live streamers on Twitch, is going to leave the platform just like Ninja to go over and exclusively stream for Mixer and Microsoft. I got to say, I love watching Shroud streams. I'm one of his biggest fans, and I got to say, this guy is awesome to watch, and this will make me want to jump over to Mixer every now and then to watch him stream. If you like first-person shooters, if you like somebody that engages with the community and is just dominant in the video game world, you gotta go check out Shroud, and now you can see him exclusively stream over on Mixer. We're gonna find out in this next couple of months, maybe 6 to a year, really what Mixer and Twitch look like as an ecosystem as more and more streamers start to really find their identity, figure out if they want to stream exclusively from Mixer, if they want to stay with Twitch or leave that ecosystem behind. A whole lot of fun, but now another big piece falling over to the Mixer side. And now for our final story of your Friday Hype Report, story number four. Death Stranding features a Conan O'Brien cameo. This story from IGN.com by Matt Perslow. The story reads, U.S. talk show host Conan O'Brien has revealed that he has a cameo in Death Stranding. In a clip uploaded to the Conan YouTube channel, O'Brien can be seen visiting the Kojima production offices during a trip to Tokyo. After a brief profile of Death Stranding, Kojima is seen asking O'Brien if he'd like to be in the game. Presumably, this was all arranged in advance in order to make a joke out of it all. So, naturally, O'Brien agrees. And so commences a bizarre facial capture session. While the clip is humorous in tone, O'Brien really is in the game. As revealed by Kojima in a tweet, O'Brien's character, the Wandering MC, will gift you a sea otter suit when you connect with him. Yes, you can dress Sam up as a sea otter and make him swim in a river like an otter. This game is absolutely insane. It's wild, it's crazy, it's wacky, it's fun. And now Conan O'Brien is going to gift me, Norman Reedus, aka Sam, a sea otter suit so I can go out there in a river and flop around and swim around. This is mind-blowing. This is insane. People already have the game. There's full spoilers up on the internet, so be careful out there, everybody, so you don't have this awesome experience ruined for you. But I gotta say, I don't know how you could be a reviewer, get this video game and see all this wacky, crazy, kooky nonsense and not go to Twitter and just say, what the heck is going on? I got to tell y'all all about this because it's insane. I love it. I cannot wait for Death Stranding to drop, and I can't wait to see the wandering MC Conan O'Brien himself gift me that sea otter suit. And with that, that will conclude this Friday, October 25th, 2019 Hype Report. It's your boy, Snowbike Mike, reminding you, if you liked any of the gaming headlines that I brought to you today, please go to the show description below. I've left you all the article links there. You can give them a click and support those incredible games journalists around the globe. You have now been caught up for your Friday, and you're ready to celebrate the weekend. You have three awesome games now released for your weekend of gameplay: Call of Duty Modern Warfare, Outer Worlds, and Medieval. So go out there, game a whole bunch, and let me know how your weekend was when I see you back here on Monday. Have a great day, gamers!